Hi guys, postman's been. Actually told us what it is. Electronic organ module. $1.49. That's interesting. Cost me £2.28, which is significantly more than that. Well, yeah. Quite a bit more than that. Anyway, let's have a look, see what's in the kit. It's just one of those ones that caught my eye when I was browsing eBay. So I quite often look to see if there are any little kits I can put together. Nothing else in the bag. So what have we got? Circuit board. Looks fairly simple. Row of buttons, row of resistors, 2.2, 2.2, 2.2, 2.2, 2.2, 2.2, 2.2, 1, 10K. Capacitor, 104, resistor, 1K. Capacitor 104, capacitor 104, NE5555 chip, little electrolytic capacitor, tags for the speaker, and that must be tags for the power in, ground and VCC. So it should be pretty simple, and it must just be based on changing the resistance across a couple of the tags on the 555 timer. So what have we got in here? We might just go straight ahead and make it, as long as I don't lose the bits. So that's our buttons. Okay. And they're all going to fit straight through like that. Yeah, it'll be all right. Okay, I think I'll set my soldering iron up. Speakers attracting everything. Couple of bits of wire for the speaker. Oh. What voltage? DC 3 to 12 volts. Okay, we should be all right there. I could probably put one of my JST connectors on there. Yeah. Right, resistors. Brown, black, red. Brown, black, red. Red, red, red. Red, red, red. Red, red, red. I think they're red. Hope they are. Red's two, isn't it? So 2-2 and two zeros. So they'll all be easy to work out. That one, that one, that one, that one, that one, that one. brown, black, orange. So brown is 1, black is 0, orange is it 3? I can't remember. That'd be right, 1, 0, 3, yeah. And then 1K and 1K, brown, black, red, brown, black, red. Yeah, I think we're okay on colours. Don't even need to check them with my meter. Those capacitors are all the 104s, they're all the same ones, and then a little electrolytic. Yeah, I'll set the soldering iron up. Right, well, while we're waiting for the soldering iron, so put these in place. Probably got the camera too close, haven't I? Getting my hand in the way. I should have pulled it back a bit and zoomed in. Okay. And the other 1K. Right, so they're all in position. See this if I'm soldering. We'll see. I have taken to putting the soldering iron, the camera, the other side of the screen, so it's upside down to me, and that usually works quite well. Ooh. Not quite positioned right to be able to see this properly. How about if we go this way round? Do that again. I must say, the solder doesn't seem to be flowing onto these tags as nicely as normally does. Even though I'm using the bigger soldering iron than I normally use. I say normally, I've been using my little USB soldering iron. Really isn't flowing in nicely. Like I ought to have gone along and cleaned all the tags first. Yeah, that's strange. That really didn't seem to want to take solder. Okay. Well, the battery's just going to go on the camera, so I'll go and change that first. Get my hand in the way again. Right, so that's our resistors. Them yet, or do we want to do the chip? Chip seems fairly happy anyway. So use some slightly finer solder. I bought some the other day in Lidl. They were selling it, which was unusual. I haven't tried it yet. I really can't see. Let's go this way around. Can't see. I've got the camera in much too close. I should have moved it when I changed the battery. Okay. Get this fellow the right way around. I'll leave the speaker till last. Let's have a look at some of these push buttons. They're going in nicely, holding themselves in place. Okay, they're all in place. Okay, that's all of them. A solder splash there. Clean it out of the way. So we got the power and the speaker. Now that flowed on there nicely. Why didn't all the others flow on nicely? It didn't want to flow on nicely to that side. Speaker. Okay, all soldered. Put my little buttons on. Don't know if there's a right and wrong way to fit them. I was missing one then. Right, what I'll do is I'll screw that tag connector into there and then we'll put some power on it. Well, I've got to say, that's disappointing. I've just powered it up, the 555 got hot and nothing happened. Unless the frequency range is too high for me to hear, which is quite possible. I'm just doing a visual check, see if there's anything I've done ridiculously wrong. Well, I can see what I've done wrong. I can't believe what I've done wrong. I've stuck the 555 upside down. How did I do that? Chatting, not paying attention, which would account for it getting hot. Well, I'll have to see if I can desolder it and turn it round. I do have a bag of them upstairs, so if I've ruined it, I can replace it. I can't believe that. Why didn't somebody shout? What's the point of having viewers if you don't shout and say, "Oi, Grandad, that's the wrong way round." The indentation, I've put it at the top there, and clearly the screen print shows it at the bottom. How did I do that? Chatting. Salvaged. Desoldered it, put it back in the right way round. Perfect! I'm running it on 12 volts at the moment. And that's not hot. So clearly putting it in upside down it didn't like. It seems to be clicking, which is interesting. Yeah, definitely a little click every so often. I expect that's one of these capacitors discharging. Anyway, so when's the best time to make a complete mess of things? When you're filming it. Because then lots of people can comment and say how stupid you are. Because I suppose that ought to be the other way around. Normally you have your low keys on the left and high keys on the right, don't you? Yeah, wonderful. Job done. Job messed up. Job salvaged. Job done.
Hey, thanks for watching. There's plenty of videos on my main channel with more added daily. So don't forget to subscribe and enable the notifications to keep you up to date with my new releases. You can help keep my channel running by donating a dollar on Patreon to buy me coffee. You can always find more information in the video description. Thanks again for watching.